Today we're going to talk about a unique problem that many of you probably have experienced. It's the n-stop switch having its metal part for the switch break off. Now this is on a printer that I just purchased that was used, so I'm going to show you how to fix this real quick. So the interesting thing is they hide it for the screws behind here to take it apart. So you're going to have to take this off, and then you're going to have to find the right size to actually change it. So give me a second to find the right tool here. Hopefully I'll find it quickly. That's too big. So I think it's 2 millimeters. Let me see if I can find that one. There we go. Let's see if I can get it in there. So apparently it's not fitting in there either. So 1.5 and 2 don't seem to fit. That's interesting. Oh, maybe it is 2. Sorry. So you're going to unscrew this. It's probably going to cause the motor to drop off for a second. But that's okay, because we have to get to the end stop sensor. So let me unscrew this real quick. So it's 4 bolts, it's the 2 millimeter size for your hex wrench, and the motor's probably going to drop off in a second, but that's immaterial to what we're talking about now, so we're not going to worry too much about that, because we can reassemble this easily by putting these screws back in. But we're interested in the actual end stop. So let's take this off. Okay, so now you can see the motor. I'm going to put that down here, but we're going to actually examine this piece here. So as you can see, this is the part inverted like so. So all you have to do is take out those Phillips head screws and you can replace it. So what we'll do here is we'll unscrew this. Let that come out. Unscrew this one. And now we're in business. So anybody that wants to find this part, I'll put it up on my Patreon account so you can find where to actually buy this, just to make your life simpler. And I'll show you how to test this real quick using the actual facility of the motherboard. Oops. Sorry, not normally trying to screw things in quickly when I do this. Okay, so the sensor's back in to test it. To make sure it's functional, I have obviously this printer that I recently purchased to rehab. So we're gonna find the X connector, and obviously it's keyed, so it's easy to do. So you're just gonna connect it here and plug it in. And then you're going to plug in your motherboard with your USB. So I'm gonna plug that in, and then we're gonna connect to this via printer face. It's a tool that I use that normally is used for just testing the functionality of the printer. I don't normally print with it anymore. I print with Cura. So let's go over and take a look real quick. Here's the actual application. I'm going to click disconnect, then connect. You can see the printer's now online. So I'm going to type M119. This will show the end stop status for things that are connected. So I may have the Y axis connected right now and the X axis. The Z is obviously not connected. So let's see what we got here. So we have two that say open. So to test this, what we can do to see if it's functioning, give me a second to actually set this up for you, is actually look at both of these. So I'm going to show you them together. So as you can see, I'm going to click it with my finger And then I'm going to do M119 again and see what happens. So it does say triggered. Now if I release it and press enter, it says open. So now we know it's functional. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and have a nice day.